Now, a wonderful vision there. Some absolute superstars that have not only played some magnificent footy here in South Australia, but many have crossed the border and played on the national stage as well. So South Australian Football Hall of Fame essentially celebrates anyone that's come out of South Australia. So even if their Sandful careers may have been pretty short because they moved on, they certainly come into the Football Hall of Fame here for South Australia. And that's quite fitting for our first inductee, because his Sandful career as a senior player only lasted 1 year, and boy, what a year it was. He comes from really good stock, this guy. His dad, uncles were playing Sandful footy. In his first year in Sandful footy as a teenager, as a schoolboy, he played 21 games and kicked 38 goals and played state football and threw seasoned players around like ragdolls. I'm talking about the great Matthew Pavlich. Pav, congratulations. Stay there, you can relax for the moment. Many of you remember watching Pav, and he came onto the scene, like I said, as a teenager, and he was built like a man, he was as strong as a man, and he just took the competition by storm. Just run through his CV. If I actually went through his whole CV, we wouldn't get to the count tonight, because it is one of the best in modern football, if not football, of all time. Six-time All-Australian, eight-time leading goal kicker at the Dockers, 700 goals across 353 games. Didn't spend all his time in the forward line, as we'll find out, of course. He went at pick number 4 in the 99 draft with big raps, and boy, did he certainly, I suppose, fill his potential, plus add a fair bit of GST on that as well, really, when you look at it. He's a member of the Australian Footy Hall of Fame. He burst on the AFL scene. I think he played one game in the Waffle in 2000. They went, we need to get this kid in the team. And his first two kicks, he kicked two goals for the Dockers, and then just went on and got better and better and better. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Matthew Pavlich. Let's have a look at some of Pav's highlights.
I think of Matthew Pavlich as a teenager playing for the Eagles, getting all the way to a preliminary final, and that set him up for one of the all-time great AFL careers. A legend at Fremantle, a six-time All-Australian player in so many different positions.
Welcoming Matthew Pavlich up to the stage. And great to have Chairman of the Sandful, Rob Kerrin, to present Pav with his Hall of Fame. We'll get a little photos over here. We'll just get that sorted, boys, and then Pav will get a little chat going. Beautiful. Righto. Good on you. Pav, congratulations. I'll let you have the lectern. You're the man. Front and centre with this, mate. Brilliant acknowledgement. You're obviously in the Australian Hall of Fame, but it must be a lovely feeling to come home and be recognised here.
Yeah, it's a great privilege, and it's fantastic to see so many familiar faces in the room and to share the night with the family and some ex-teammates on our table, some other people in the room that I've got a lot of connection with. SA and Adelaide was where I grew up and loved my time, and all I really wanted to do was play one game for Woodville West Torrens, having the rich history with Dad and yep. my uncles yep. at West Torrens. I just wanted to play one game, and then that led on to the next. So to be recognised tonight in the names, it was 214 other legends of our game. It's a great privilege.
Bev, I want to ask, because obviously with the family and when you're, you know, a son of a gun, there's always a bit of hype around as you're growing up, and you're obviously a wonderful, wonderful junior footballer. But I've got to ask, I think you were destined for the big stage even before you popped your head into the world, because you're a December 31 baby, aren't you? Yeah. So obviously Mum Jan's there, Steve's there. You actually waited for the big stage and popped your head out at 11:45 on New Year's Eve. So you pretty much disrupted and interrupted Mum and Dad's chances of bringing the new year.
Yeah, Mum couldn't hold on any longer, apparently. She let us down that night. We were hoping for the front page, you know.
Yeah.
New Year's Eve baby.
First baby.
Thanks, Mum.
Well, Pab, you made up for it because there are a million other front pages down the track. As a young man, though, I've got to say, and you've got to some of your Eagles teammates that you played with there in 99. You were a 17-year-old school kid. Geez, you took to Sandford footy bloody well, bloody quickly. Did you just feel like you were ready to go?
Not really. I think it was the years at Sacred Heart and through my under-17s and under-19s career that I grew more confident. We had a rich history in the under-19s in 1998. We were talking about it before, but we won the premiership against Port Adelaide that year.
Yep.
With the likes of Matthew Whelan, Ken McGregor. There was a number of guys that went through that team together, and then that helped us in the season 99. Stephen Hall was reminding us earlier that we were predicted to finish last in 1999. But, you know, we had a big bunch of young players. Rhett Biglands came back and a number of others, and we played in a prelim. So, I just got confidence from the players that I played around. And you get confidence when you play with other good players at Sacred Heart. We had a great team there.
I just want to ask you, you played this state game, and I think it was the curtain raiser before the last State of Origin game, and you're playing over in Melbourne or so, and you've got plenty of your Eagles teammates in the squad as well, which was great. So you would have only played a handful of senior Sandful games. You're playing for the state. Now, there was a lot of hype on you, right? This is from what I understand. So you had some of your teammates there, but everyone wanted to meet you because the AFL State of Origin was going after all the stars were in the same hotel. Right now, I don't know how much of this is still in your memory, but I believe all the scouts and everyone's going, this bloke Pavlich is going to be a star. You know, you look like you were so big, you look like you were probably shaving in primary school and that sort of thing, and you would have driven your car to an under-12 game rather than ride a push bike because you were a man. So you got all these guys, Paul Roos and Gary Ayres, coming into breakfast going, this is the guy. Greg Anderson, of course everyone knows Greg Anderson, he was a selector. And the story goes, Pavel, I need to just check that this is correct. It's not an urban legend. He's come in and they all want to meet this young bloke who's going to be a star. So Greg Anderson walks in. You're all sitting at breakfast and he's looked around. You've got your teammates and he's sort of a bit dumbfounded and gone, oh, this is Ruzier. This is Rex Biglands. This is Gavin Corville. He's looked at Stephen Hall and drew a blank. This is, don't worry about him. And this is Matthew Pavlich. So all these seasoned blokes, they just didn't care less. Everyone was going at you. Did you feel that pressure?
Not at all. I don't know what you're talking about. No, I do. Yeah, I do remember a similar story to that, which was, I mean, I looked up to those guys. So it was, very humbling at that time. But, yeah, the hype was real on that stage. I was still at school and, playing in the SANFL and living a bit of a dream, playing for my beloved Eagles. And it was, then I got a bit overwhelmed that night. I won't tell that story, Rex. We can maybe share that afterwards, but overwhelmed that night.
You were rooming with Rex, and Stephen Hall made sure you got to bed okay, so you didn't damage any, it was a big night, though.
We had a good time, yes.
Good boy. Well done. Pep, I've got to ask, because your versatility is remarkable. I mean, have a look at the size of you. You're a massive unit, but midfield, I think your first All-Australian was fullback. You were picked as an All-Australian as a half-forward flanker, as a centre-half forward, as a full forward, as the fullback we said there, and a couple of times on the bench. I think the versatility, and we see that even now with guys, but yours is probably, I think, as diverse as anyone we can remember playing the game. Was there one place that you liked to play more? Did you want to just get in the midfield?
Oh, no, I mean, I was a natural forward. I played most of my junior footy as a centre-half forward. So forward was my natural role, but, Dad's here who I guess is really, who really shaped my entire career about learning different positions. He himself played midfield, halfback, half forward. And I think there was a great strength of not only my career, but if you look at common players these days, modern day players, the best strengths that they can have impact all over the field. And no matter if the day's not going their way, they can still impact the game in some way. So I may not have been playing that well as a forward, but could go and maybe potentially have some time in the midfield. So generally a forward, but tried to fill some gaps, particularly as we were developing as a younger team and didn't necessarily have such a strong team. I'd have to go and fill some gaps, but I think it actually helped me better understand the game and look at it as I do now.
Your consistency was unbelievable. Across 17 years, I think you had 1 year with the Achilles that kept you 12 games. All the others were 18, 19, 20 and so forth. Just from that, and obviously there's so much attention in WA, did you ever consider coming home? Did you get close? Because there obviously were a lot of offers all the time.
Yeah, no, I got very close to coming back to Port Adelaide at the end of 2002, which has been pretty well documented throughout Adelaide as well at the end of 2007, and then Gold Coast as well, and a few of the big Melbourne clubs. But whilst I entertained those offers and obviously had those discussions, after I'd signed that second deal, I was so personally invested into the club, into the people you meet. I had made a big move originally, and I felt I wanted to see that through. And what I initially thought may have been 2 years ended up 17 as a player and has been 22 as a person over in WA. I love Adelaide. I love coming back to South Australia. But, yeah, my life after that initial period was well and truly entrenched in WA.
You're proud you're a one club man?
Absolutely, yeah. Would have been nice to have got some silverware at the end there in 2013 or 2015. But, loyalty is a big part of what I was taught growing up. And sticking at something that you think it's worthwhile enough. And I look back now and don't look at any regrets or anything in the past and know that that loyalty and that love and that respect has been returned to me in so many ways and my family. So, it would have been nice to have lifted the cup, but feel very much fulfilled and content that I played my career at Frio.
Just before I hand over for you to thank, I'm sure, a lot of people, just a quick one. Obviously, as you said, Dad, your uncles were such a big influence, and I'm sure Mum was as well. What did they teach you as a young bloke that helped you go on to achieve what you achieved then and certainly what you're achieving in business now?
Competitiveness. Every Christmas lunch or barbecue or... and that's, both the Pavlicers and the Lip family, we had lots of cousins, and it was always a game of cricket and basketball and footy, and it was like at every turn it was competitive. And on one side of the family, I was one of the younger members of our group, and on the other side, I was the eldest. And so... it taught me lots of lessons. My uncles always used to give me lots of lessons in the backyard and Dad as well. So, competitiveness and hopefully succeeding.
Well, you've certainly done that and you'll continue to do it, Pav. Congratulations. I'm sure there's some people you'd love to thank. Yeah.
Thank you. I'd like to thank, in particular here in South Australia, I guess the two groups that I had my most football memories or experiences with, and that's Sacred Heart College and also the Woodville West Torrens Footy Club. I could name individuals, coaches, players, teammates, support staff, so many people that have put so much time and effort into not only me but to our groups that I played alongside. I could spend all night doing that, but I just want to thank them as a whole. I loved my time at Sacred Heart. I absolutely love my time at Woodville West Torrens. So I want to pass on my very best to everyone that I was involved with at those two organisations. Obviously, the Fremantle Footy Club gave me my start. So many great people. Footy's great because you get to express yourself in a true sense. I tried hard in the classroom. I try hard in other areas of my life. But football and the ground and the experiences where I truly expressed myself, and I got to do that with one particular club in the AFL, and so many people supported me on that journey there through the good times and bad, they've just been tremendous. My family, Mum and Dad, my sister Jess, her partner Ben here in South Australia, I don't get to see them anywhere near as much as I'd like in person, given my life over in Western Australia, but I mean the unwavering support and riding the roller coaster of an AFL career, people in the room will understand what that looks like and what that feels like, the ups and downs and everything in between. Couldn't thank you guys enough for everything that you've done. And Lauren, my wife, and my three children, our three children back in WA, incredible support, and we're now living our life through them, given the fact that we're at school sport every weekend. So thank you to them, thank you to Lauren, and thank you to the SNFL for this wonderful acknowledgement. I've always loved the SNFL, always a huge support, and look forward to having a great night. Thank you.
Congratulations, Matthew Pavlich, our first inductee into the Hall of Fame. Stephen Hall, don't worry, we all remember your name. Okay, you're a wonderful fullback at the Eagles for many years. You're in the team of the decade and everything. So if Greg Anderson couldn't remember, shame on him. We all know who you are, Hawley. Well done, mate.